Webb is just weeks away before it's fully operational, and NASA has already revealed its first targets, two hot super-Earths. One is covered in lava, and the other has no air. The first one is 55 Cancri E, an exoplanet 40 light-years from us. It's covered in lava oceans and orbits extremely close to its parent sun-like star, so close that an entire year lasts only a few hours. We should be thankful that Earth lies at just the right distance from the sun. Too close, and its oceans would boil away. Too far, and it would freeze. This world is less than 1.5 million miles from its host star, 1/25th of the distance between Mercury and the Sun, and completes one revolution about every 18 hours. But there's something way more interesting about this exoplanet. A planet that orbits this close to its parent star is usually tidally locked, meaning one side always faces its star. This implies that the star-facing side would be much hotter than the dark side. But surprisingly, this doesn't seem to be the case for 55 Cancri E. One explanation could be that the planet has a dynamic atmosphere that moves heat around. Heat could circulate from the day side to the dark side of the planet. While this could be a very interesting case, there could be something even more exciting happening over here. It could be that the planet not only is home to lava oceans, but also lava rain. Nevertheless, this is why NASA wants to investigate this world using Webb. Webb's cutting-edge instruments, the near-infrared camera, NIRCam, and mid-infrared instrument, MIRI, will be able to see what optical telescopes can't. Now, the second target exoplanet is the somewhat cooler super-Earth, LHS 3844b. This planet will give us a golden opportunity to study an exoplanet's solid rock surface. This world lies a bit farther away from us than 55 Cancri E, about 49 light-years away in the constellation of Indus. LHS 3844 orbits even closer to its star than 55 Cancri E and could be tidally locked. It takes about 11 hours to orbit around its star, but it's still not as hot as 55 Cancri E, and that's mainly due to its star's relatively small size and cooler temperature. So the exoplanet isn't hot enough for its surface to melt. And here comes the interesting part. Data from NASA's Spitzer Space Telescope suggests that this exoplanet is airless, meaning it doesn't have an atmosphere and is more or less like Mercury. Again, Webb could be the hero of the night. While Webb won't be able to image the surface directly, due to the lack of an obscuring atmosphere, the telescope could investigate the surface with spectroscopy. For this, Webb will use its mid-infrared instrument to detect the presence of different rock compositions, like basalt and granite, and perhaps even volcanic gas. By studying these worlds, humans will have a chance to better understand our own planet's past. This will help us understand what the infant Earth might have been like when it was super hot, just like these exoplanets. If you like this video, please consider subscribing and click the notification bell so you do not miss any upcoming videos.